Fuck. I thought I had recorded for many turns, but now I've been speaking constantly, and then I realized when the game crashed, the recording stopped to record. In some games, when you exit the game and get back to the desktop, the program I used, the Nvidia recorder Shadowplay, it still records after you crash. In Medieval 2 it would still record, but in this game it somehow didn't. So I've been thinking, I was thinking I was recording, so I've been speaking for a couple of turns now, and then I realized it wasn't on. So we are at the year 1943 now, and the game hasn't crashed again since the last time, and yeah, we will continue and save each turn and hope it won't crash. The goal of this campaign is to find out if we can continue the entire campaign, or if we will crash sooner or later and won't be able to, just restart and continue. Because I know it will crash, but as long as we can restart the game, load the save and continue, I'm fine with it. But if we can't, I know we can restart the game and I know we can load the save, but if we can't click next turn without having the same crash happen again and again and again at the same turn, then the campaign won't be like playable in the long run, because you can't finish it, because it will crash sooner or later at the same spot no matter what. So the goal of this campaign is to find out if it's possible to finish the campaign or not. By continuing the campaign as long as we can. No matter if we need to restart it quite sometimes. In the earlier version I needed to restart the game 2 times until I reached 1946. Between 1942 and 1946, I only had 2 crashes. We'll see how it is this time, if I can even reach 1946. So, I'll resolve all the battles. We're not interested in fighting any battles. I'm only interested in the campaign stability. So, alright, I believe I showed the map previously, but you can see we have Europe, the Soviet Union, Germany, the other Axis powers, we have Africa. Over here we have like Asia, Japan, China, Thailand, India and Britain. We have some isles here with Japan and the US and Britain. We have South America with the League of Nations. The League of Nations is the Roman Senate and the Free French, the United States and the British Commonwealth, aka the British Empire, they are the Roman factions, they are allied. That's why the US will never take South America, or most likely won't, because that would mean they would attack the Senate. And they are also allied with the British, of course, through the Roman system of the Senate, so they are less likely to attack the British as well. Alright, let's just continue. We will save. I don't think I did it this turn, so we will save now and then we will click next turn again. We are on turn on the year 1943. We will continue as long as we can. Hopefully at least to the year 1946, if we are able to do that. We'll see. So I'm back, I crashed, so we will try again now, see if we... Fuck, I needed to click that thread. I fucked up. So if we crash now, we will start again. Good that we were attacked, and I can click here. We always need to click that symbol when loading a save, because otherwise the scripts are not active, and the game will be very unstable, and the turns per year won't work. So always click that symbol when restarting. Sometimes it's hard to to be fast enough to click it, because it shows up and then it disappears. But as soon as someone attacks you, it will show up if it's not active. And that's when you have the time to click on it. But if they don't attack you, then you end up having 1944 immediately. Anyway, Outer solved that battle. Hopefully we won't get stuck again. Dagovax has sent me an updated version of the dev launcher. Oh, it didn't crash. That's good. But it usually won't crash the first two tries after having a crash. Like, you can load it and go back to the game, and then you can continue, and then it crashes again sometime later, and then you can load it and continue. And then on the third time, or fourth time or something like that, then you can't continue because it will happen again and again and again. That's what we're gonna test. As I said, Dagovax just sent me an updated launcher, so I have the possibility to upgrade the mod into the recent version with the custom cities and tracks on the roads and modern ships instead of these ships here, the fishing boats or whatever. But I won't do that because I'm busy, like, trying this out now. I want to first finish this and after that update. Maybe his version is more stable, or maybe not. We'll see. I will try it immediately after I'm done with this. But for now, let's just save the game and then click next turn, and we will continue doing this until we can't go forward in the campaign. That's when we will exit and of course upgrade the mod and then try again with the new version and see if it's more stable or as unstable as this one. And if you're lucky here, it will be possible to always continue. That's what I am hoping for. That's the goal of these attempts to try the campaign out. That I want to find out if I can finish a campaign if I just restart and load the save game. If it's not possible, we have a big problem, because then no player will be able to actually play the campaign to the end, which is bad. Because at the end of the day, I think most people play the campaign, not custom battles. Custom battles are fine. They work fine. And historical battles as well, and ship battles, which is historical battles. You can't have ships in the campaign. The only way to have real-time battles with ships in the campaign is if you don't have land battles at all, and instead have the ships be the land battles, and then you don't have ships at all. So, in other words, if you make a campaign where the ships are the land troops and the sea is the land, then of course it would work, but you can't have both land battles and ship battles in the campaign at once, because the option to play ship battles in real time doesn't exist. In custom battle and historical battles, the ships are actually land units. So, it only works in historical battles and in custom battles unless you have a ship-only campaign. I can see why why Dagovax and Salazar didn't want a ship battle-only campaign. However, that could be an option for a separate version of the mod, like a ship version where you only fight naval battles. That could work. Then you could have like a naval battle campaign. But if you want both ships and land units, then you can't have the ships in battle. Of course, we could have ships in battle in this campaign if they fight on land, but that would look very off. Then the ships would move on grass and stuff like that. If you want them in on water, you need to have the battlefields be water. And you can't have land battles at all. Because the ship battles in Rome and Medieval 2 are automatic. So the only way to go around that is to make them land battles. And by doing that, you probably can't have the land units instead. So have at least reached 1946 in prior versions of this mod. So it's not impossible to move to 1946 in other versions. I hope it will be possible here as well. As I said, the quick saves and the auto saves are unreliable, while the manual saves are more stable. People even say that you should deactivate the autosave function to have the game be more stable, but usually that won't help in my opinion. I think the game continues to CD no matter if I have autosaves on or not. Most of the time the autosave work, but yeah, the manual saves are more stable, so that's why we are going with them, even though it's annoying to have to save every turn. Yeah, it feels like a chore, but yeah, it's part of the playtesting work, I guess. I'm the playtester pretty much. I did the quotes and the unit, the faction descriptions, but for this mod I'm mostly playtesting because I have more free time than dagovax and Salazar, even though my free time is about to reach an end too. You know, I need to get a job and I need to start to work and all that, but for now I have the time to playtest. Of course, any player can be seen as a playtester, but I don't believe a lot of the players actually report issues. And if they do, it's usually just the same stuff we have already seen. So. Quite a few turns. I think it takes forever to click next turn and next turn and next turn. In Medieval 2 you can play hot seat and then you can place the all the factions under AI control, even the rebels. Like you start a console and then you click and then you write control and then you write the name of the faction you want the AI to control. Your own faction, that is. You use the code name for the faction, the name it has in the desk strat, but it isn't possible in single player, only in hot seat. And as Rome.war doesn't have hot seat, that's not possible. But of course, it's possible to add hot seat to Rome, but that was the mod, I believe. Yeah, Lord of the Rings.war has it. But I don't think the code would work in hot seat, even in Rome. Which is sad, because then I don't have to click next turn. It would happen automatically. But on the other hand, I would need to have it like this in order to be able to create manual saves. Otherwise I would run into that CTD and won't be able to, you know, continue at a certain point. Because I would be dependent on the autosaves, and as you know, they are like unreliable. So they are more unreliable in Medieval 2, I believe, but they are still unreliable there as well. So the campaign is moving on. Things are happening, but not that much has happened yet. We are still on in the year of 1943, so no hurry, I guess. Campaign is 300 turns in total between 1942 and 1954. It will take a long time to finish a campaign. Every year is 24 turns. So 24 turns is a year, and all the years in total are 300 turns. Which is a lot. It takes a lot of time. Even when I just click next turn and save. We are attacked at Dhaka. We will of course just auto-resolve. We're not interested in any real-time battle. Still at 1943. Ships are much more active in this game than in Medieval 2, that's very good. The AI is also way more aggressive. All the factions are aggressive, not just a few. In Medieval 2, you need enhanced AI mods in order to make the AI this aggressive. In Rome to the War, the AI is very aggressive from vanilla state, so the vanilla AI in Rome to the War is very aggressive, while Medieval 2, the vanilla AI is very, very inactive. So in order to make it aggressive, you need to add mods that enhance it. So I'd say Rome has the better AI from the vanilla game. But with mods, you can make Medieval 2 just as good, or almost as good. Now we are at 1944, so I managed to reach 1944. However, that doesn't answer the question if it's stable or possible to play the entire campaign, because I had the CTD at a certain turn in 1945. So I believe the campaign could work well until 1945 at least. But that CTD, it happens randomly. It could happen in this year, it could happen in 1945, it could happen in 1947. Or 1953, I don't know. We'll see if it happens or not. So Japan has reached India. Germany just took Rome and Napoli. At war with Italy. They've also taken all the minor factions here, with the exception of Hungary. And taken one area from Turkey. So Turkey is in a war with Germany now. We also have some Spanish troops there. On that note, Germany is also at war with Spain. Has taken Barcelona. Right, and in Africa they still are holding Tunis with the Americans on the border. The British have taken Tripoli from the Italians, and Benghazi from the Germans actually. So we have the French and the British and the US. Here we have the Vichy French. Italy has been totally crushed as expected. Germany has lost one of their two areas, but they are still holding Tunis and now trying to combine it with the rest of the Reich by crushing and taking the areas here from Italy. And they are also moving into Turkey to reach the oil fields here in the Middle East. I don't know how the war against Russia is progressing, but Russia seems to still be strong. They are far from defeating Russia. In one try, they actually managed to take all the areas down here, and then all the areas here, and even took Aleppo. Then they had all their armies on the border here. they also had taken Spain and all the minor factions they had, all the areas here. They didn't take Portugal, so it was still free, but everything else. And then they had Tunis and the entirety of Italy. They had lost Benghazi too. But their armies here were supposed to move down and into Africa, but I quit that campaign. Alright, let's continue playtesting. I also had one where Japan took the entirety of this area, India, China, only a few areas of Thailand were free. They had also most of the ISILs here. They didn't have these ISILs, they were still held by America. Thailand had moved down one troop to this ISILs, so they also used to move troops with their ships. They can do that, and then they were at war with the Soviet Union, the Japanese. They had taken one area maybe. Yeah, but the Soviet Union still held most of their areas. So next turn. The US is quite active in Africa and on the ISILs in the Pacific. They don't do much more than that. Maybe the US should have one of the Chinese areas. They were in history. They were active in helping the Chinese. They had one in particular like Air Force unit here. Maybe they should have one of the areas here so they could get some incentive to send the troops there. Because I think the US should have more of a role in China, but yeah, maybe. Otherwise they will most likely just get stuck here, see all these troops. So, but if they already held all the territory in Asia, they might actually send troops there. Alright, next turn. Because unlike in Medieval 2, the AI actually use ships to move troops. They don't just use them to, you know, blockade ports. So let's say, and next turn. To resolve this, of course. So we're going to auto-resolve all battles. Takes too much to fight them. Especially when we are sucky units. Like the rebels. The rebels don't have anything good anyway. Just infantry, I believe. Let's save. Japan has expanded a lot in Asia now, despite being nerfed in the recent updates. Britain has taken most of Africa as expected. Let's save the game. And next turn. These horse caravans here, they will be replaced with actual trucks in the update. The fishing boats will have actual modern ships, pretty cool. And the roads will be modern. Very good for immersion. both the strat map and in the battles. So that's a cool feature. Let's save the game. Hate replaying stuff. So, next turn. I have the League of Nations there. Alright, save again. Resolve this battle as well. And save the game. And next turn. So this is a lot of the work when modding. You need to play test campaigns. Some modders prefer to release betas or alphas and let the players report the bugs. Basically the players will become the play testers by doing that. I also do that from time to time, but I can tell you that when I mod I usually play a lot myself in order to try the changes out after every major like modding spree. Every time I change the game by quite some every time I've changed something I used to, you know, play test mod. And if there are a lot of changes, then of course I need to play test it longer. And I play tested a lot of mods, like this mod Warcraft Total War, Hyrule Total War, Republic of China, Wrath of the Northmen, Last Kingdom, Game of Thrones, you name it, even East of Rome, and some other unreleased mods, Morrowind, Total War. So, in other words, I've done a lot of playtesting. A lot of time is spent on playing the game, just to see that it works after you change something. And as you change things, quite often and a lot, then that means I need to play test the game a lot. But unlike when you are playing the game, you won't have the time to, you know, finish an entire campaign every time you play test. Instead it's more about like playing 50 turns, 20 turns, 100 turns, 300 turns, 500 turns, and then nothing more. And usually you don't even play battles, you just click next turn and see if the game works or if you need to fix it or whatever. Medieval 2 has a log where you can see errors, even though it's hard to read, but it still has a log. Rome Total War doesn't even have a log, so it's harder to know the cause of certain city. That's why I prefer Medieval 2 when it comes to solving bugs. Let's save the game. There are a few CTD in Rome Total War that you can like get a hint on what is causing the crash. For example, if there is a missing texture, then you will have like a text telling you that as the reason for why it crashed, but there is no log. So if it's CTD without a message, then you're left to your own devices to figure out the reason, unfortunately. So we'll save again. We are still on the year 1942. Germany has taken some areas of Turkey, but they still haven't taken Ankara, the capital. They've taken all the other Turkish settlements. They've also taken all the Italian settlements and united those areas with Tunis here. They are on their way into the Middle East. Yeah, they also have some areas here. They still haven't beaten Spain. If you look at Japan, they have taken half of India and taken the entirety of Thailand. Thailand is no more. Alright. Save the game, not quit the game. Alright. So I'm back, the game crashed of course. So we will continue, we need to click this symbol. Of course. So scripts are active. We will click next turn and hope it won't crash again at the same location. It crashed on the British turn the last time. Which is normal. But it's not normal if it happens again and again. It didn't happen now, so we can continue. Good. As long as it isn't happening at the same spot when restarting and loading a save, it's fine. So let's click next turn. Hope we will be in the year 1945 soon. We will save each and every turn, just in case it's CD. In this game, you will always need to save before and after battles if you don't want to risk having to replay stuff. But I also highly suggest you should save at least every 5 turns, but if you want to be secure, then save every turn like I do now. I know it's a chore, but that's the only way of being safe if that CD happens. Otherwise you'd need to replay a few turns when it's CD, because this game is not stable in the on the map. A lot of my Medieval 2 mods are very stable on the map. But CTD in battle because of too many polygons and such. But this game is the opposite. It's pretty much stable in battle, but CTD a lot on the map. So in order to avoid that, always save every turn if you want to be secure. At least I think that will make you secure, but that's what we are going to find out, if it will save you in the end. It might not be enough. So next turn, because if you can't finish a campaign, that ruins the whole thing. That's at least my reason for wanting to play a game like this, is to play an epic campaign and take the entire world as one of the factions. Custom battles can be fun for a while, but sooner or later you get bored. Well, the campaign is different every time because AI acts differently from every campaign, and yeah, it's like a new experience every campaign, and especially if you play different factions as well. No campaign is the other like. Custom battles on the other hand are the same, of course. So let's save. be very equal between between Germany and Soviet Union. They expanded now. Alright, we saw some expansion in Africa as well. I believe the United States or the French took an area here. The French did. Yeah. And then Germany took an area here. We took Rostov-Nadon. Alright. And Japan is expanding ever further into India. Alright, next time. It's kind of interesting to see how the AI will do if we are the rebels and all the factions are the AI. Usually the smaller factions are beaten, and because the AI is very aggressive, and then they will fight the bigger factions. The war will be between the bigger ones. If you're a smaller faction, you're kind of fucked. Anyway, next turn. Not only are the small factions weaker when it comes to their size and number of armies, but they also have worse troops. For example, Bulgaria, Turkey, Hungary and Romania, they have German troops and Italian style troops, mostly German, and yeah, they only have the lesser troops. They have just as good infantry, even better, they have cavalry, infantry and cavalry, but they have worse tanks and worse artillery and worse planes. Their best planes and tanks are either the best of Germany or like the medium, so Germany has all they have, but more, so that's why they are kind of without a chance there. Finland has some unique stuff that makes them different, but still they have like two areas, so they can't really win against Germany or the Soviet Union. They will be crushed because of their numbers and weak position when it comes to number of settlements, etc. We are in the year 1945 now. We'll see if we can reach 1946 or not. If I reach 1946, I might continue. If I can't, then I will update again. We have Spanish armies in Britain. Interesting. Fleet has sent them here. Some generals. Family member, Adolfo Bellin. And a family member here, Keisuke Bellin. Two Bellins. They invaded Britain but didn't succeed, it would seem. That's interesting. The Rome Total War AI can sometimes send armies to factions far away from their regions. In Medieval 2, the AI will never attack a faction that isn't a neighbor. But here they can like attack an area over here, even though they have their base here. So that's pretty cool. It seems Madrid has fallen to the Germans as well. But they still have Sevilla, their new city. The recently released update. So we save the game again. And next turn immediately. Let's Germans in the area of in the African area of Tunis, or at least they are on their way to fight the Germans there. I don't remember if I used save, but in case we didn't, a short time memory can be bad from time to time. I think on other stuff and forget, but yeah, we saved and now next turn. So it's an auto resolve here, so sometimes the cities will revolt, and as I am the rebels now, I will then have to auto resolve. The Soviet Union took back Novosibirsk. Right, let's see. Can't be too fast. I almost forgot to save there. Alright, and next turn. Auto resolve. Portugal took back that area. We have fleet battle between rebel ships, troopers. All factions have troopers. And of course, some faction ships. Didn't crash good. Save the game. Next turn again. Yeah, I'm starting to expand into the Soviet Union now. Alright. How to resolve this battle. US took Seattle back from the rebels. Seems the Germans have reached the Middle East now. I need to take a look at their frontier first. Kalinin, Leningrad, they even took Helsinki, the Finnish capital. The Soviets are holding the other Finnish area of Petrosavodsk. Finland is defeated. Germany is holding all these Soviet areas here. They are not holding the Finnish area of Petrosavodsk or the Russian area of Yaroslavl. And they aren't holding the Soviet Union area of Kazan either, but it's under siege now, so they will probably take it soon. Soviet is not beaten yet, but they don't have a lot of stuff left. Germany has taken Stalingrad and Kibyshev and Penza. How is the front going here? They have taken they have not taken Ankara. The British have taken Ankara from the Turks. Alright. And the French, the Free French, are still holding Aleppo. And we have the British here. So the Germans have still not taken the entirety of Turkey. I was wrong there, it was the Brits. Alright. Let's save the game. Almost the entirety of India has fallen to Japan now. Most of Africa to the British. And time to save again. Free battle can only be auto resolved. Alright. And we are still on the year of 1945. course this game is not historically accurate, because neither of the Axis powers seem to be defeated. And they probably won't be defeated anytime soon. Alright. If you placed allies, you could of course kill them off, but otherwise they are pretty strong if played by the AI, and if I as a player am not playing anyone. Alright. The minor factions couldn't stop Germany, for example. And Soviet doesn't seem to be able to stop them either, because half their country is like on the other side of the map, so they only had half their strength. Unlike in history, where they could move the rest of their armies from this area to the east, they won't be able to do that here. Let's click next turn. You can only do that if they move through the entire map, or if you use a sheet. So India's fallen, and the British areas in India too. Portugal is still holding a territory there too. Or two. Take a look at it. I believe Portugal is holding two areas here, yes. Well, Britain has lost their territory. They have one area up here, Peshawar. And then of course, they might, the Soviets are holding this area, Tashkent. And then the Indians are crushed. The free Indians. Britain is also holding Colombo. The ISIL over there. So next turn. I believe it crashed. Yeah. Let's restart it. Hello, so I'm back. I had some trouble because the recording program didn't activate when I restarted the game. But I managed to get it to work now. So it works again. Good. But the print screen doesn't work for some reason. It worked in the past, earlier today, but it stopped working. However, the video recording works. But nothing happens when I click on the button for taking screenshots. However, we loaded the save, and because we crashed, and now we will click enter and hope it won't crash again at the same spot. So it's the USSR, I believe it crashed on the French turn, now it crashed on the USSR turn, I believe. If it looks like this. Hello again! We crashed immediately, but it didn't crash on the French turn, it crashed on the Soviet turn. Usually it locks itself up. When clicking next turn, it will lock itself up on the AI's turn, at a random faction's turn, and then it will CTD a few seconds later. We can hope it won't happen now, but most likely it will. We will activate the script as always and click next turn. There's a small sound before it locks itself. The screen goes into a game lock, and after that it will crash after like 2 or 3 seconds, so yeah, it will probably happen. I give up if it happens now, it's the third time. The French did, yeah, it happened. We can't move forward a certain turn on the year 1945. Alright.